my dear lovely students. How are you all doing today? I hope all of you are well and good. So without taking much of the time, let's go directly to our chapter. What was our chapter name? It was Knowing the Plant World Closely. Right. Okay. So what did we learn in the past classes? Do you all remember? Yes, obviously you'll remember. You all are very good students, right? Yes. So tell me, what all did we learn? At the first, we learned about the edible parts of the plant. The parts of the plant we eat, right? Yes. Then what did we learn? We learned about photosynthesis, which is the process by which plants make food for themselves with the help of sunlight, carbon dioxide and water. Isn't it so? Yes. Then we learned about chlorophyll, a pigment which traps sunlight and also gives green color to the leaves. Then we learned about different colors of leaves. There also we learned three pigments. What were they? Tell me. First one was chlorophyll, then we had three of them. Which were them? Tell me loudly, I cannot hear you. Good children, yes. One was carotene, right? Then the other was xanthophyll, remember xanthophyll? Which gives yellow color. Then we had one more which gives red color, which was anthocyanin. Very good children, you remember, right? So today we are going to take a little more part of that chapter. Today what we are going to learn is, have you ever wondered, my dear children? Plants are living things, right? And they take in carbon dioxide. But that is for making food. Do they breathe also? All living things need to breathe oxygen to live, right? So do plants breathe? If so, then how? So today we'll be discussing about whether plants breathe or not and when do they breathe. Are you ready? Are you ready, my dear students? Yes. So then, let's go. So my dear students, today's first topic is photosynthesis and respiration. What is respiration? It is the breathing, right? The process of breathing is known as respiration. What is photosynthesis? You already know, as we discussed, is the process of making food in plants. Can you see this picture over here? What is given in that? Says a blue atmosphere is given in the middle, and on one side we have trees, that's plants, and then on the other side we have animals, humans, and again plants and trees. Okay, plants and trees are included on both sides. Can you see it is included on both sides? Isn't it so? So now what is given? Then there are some red arrows. Okay, they're saying that from the atmosphere. Atmosphere, where is the atmosphere? It is the air around us, right? Yes. So from this atmosphere, carbon dioxide is taken in by the plants. For what is carbon dioxide taken to the plants? For photosynthesis. And what does the plant give out during photosynthesis? It gives out the oxygen. Okay. Now in the next part, we are saying carbon dioxide is released by humans, plants and animals, and oxygen is taken from them, from the atmosphere, by for the process of respiration. So can you see the plants in both? Plants take in oxygen as well as carbon dioxide. Plants take oxygen for what? For their respiration, for breathing. Post their survival. Now what about the other plants, other trees? The trees take carbon dioxide also. For what? For the process of photosynthesis. Okay, there is a difference. They take oxygen for respiration and carbon dioxide for photosynthesis. Now, do plants release only oxygen at all times? That is the question given here. According to what ma'am said now, does plant only release oxygen? No, it gives out carbon dioxide too, right? When do they give out carbon dioxide? When respiration takes place. Respiration is the breathing. Okay? Is it clear? Yes. Now, is photosynthesis possible at night? Have you ever thought? What are the requirements of photosynthesis? Carbon dioxide, water. One major factor. Tell me, chlorophyll is the one which captures that. The sunlight, right? At night, is sunlight available? No. So, my dear children, photosynthesis only happens during daytime. At night, the plants respire. Photosynthesis does not go on. So, plants do not release oxygen during night. Okay, there are few very rare plants that give out a little oxygen at night, but most of the trees do not give out oxygen at night. They only give out carbon dioxide like all of us. Okay, my dear children, so photosynthesis does not take place in the night. It only takes place in the day. Why? Because sunlight is an essential part of photosynthesis. One simple question. You learned this, right? What is the process that takes place during the day and the night in all organisms, including plants? We learned two processes, photosynthesis and respiration. Now, which is that process that happens along all day and night in all organisms, including plants? Even plants also, this happens day and night. Which among the respiration or photosynthesis? Tell me, it is respiration, right? Very good, children. I know you will get the answer. Why? Because photosynthesis only takes place during the day, right? Yes. So now we have a question, okay? Does a person who sleeps under the tree during night receive more oxygen? They're asking, when a person, plants release oxygen, so when we go sleep under it during night, will he or she get more oxygen? Will that person get more oxygen? No, right? Why? Because during night, plants give out carbon dioxide. It is not oxygen. So maybe at times, if a person go and sleep under a tree during night, they will feel suffocation because they are also releasing carbon dioxide. The plants are also releasing carbon dioxide. They are not getting the pure fresh air. Okay? So they won't receive more oxygen. They will receive more carbon dioxide. Now, can you see the green box there? Yes. Let's read that, okay? When green plants carry out photosynthesis during daytime, carbon dioxide is absorbed and oxygen is released. That is, green plants carry out photosynthesis during daytime, right? We learned it. And what happens there? Carbon dioxide is absorbed. Absorbed means taken in. And oxygen is released, that is given out. Okay? So during daytime, photosynthesis takes place. Carbon dioxide is taken in by the plants and oxygen is given out from the plants. The second point is, since photosynthesis does not take place at night, oxygen is not released. So during the night time, oxygen is not released from the plants. All organisms, including plants, respire day and night. Oxygen is taken in and carbon dioxide is given out during that time. So we learned in that above question that all organisms, including us, including the living things and also the plants, respire day and night. That is, we breathe every time. We breathe at night also, right? Yes. We breathe in the day also. So at that time, what happens? In photosynthesis, carbon dioxide is taken in and oxygen is given out. The direct opposite happens here. The carbon dioxide, oxygen is taken in and carbon dioxide is given out. Okay. Is it clear?
Yes.
Now, we are going to the next topic. A place to live. A place to live. Where do we live on? We live on our earth. Do you all write diaries? Some of you might not. That's a very nice hobby. You can write down what all happened in your day in the diary. Okay? A book in which we write what happened in our daily lives is called a diary. Now let's see the diary writing of Sophia, a student like you. Okay, she went for a study tour from school and she's writing her experience. We will just read that out. Today we went on a study tour from school. The orchidarium attracted me the most. Orchidarium is a garden where orchid varieties are grown. How beautiful are the orchid flowers. What surprised me was the way the plants are being nurtured. They are grown on hanging wooden plants, tied with materials like coconut fiber. Some others grow on branches of trees. They don't require soil to grow. Okay. So where did Sophia go? Sophia went to an orchidarium. What is this orchidarium? Have you heard about orchidarium? Orchidarium is a place where we grow orchids. Only orchids. Orchids is a type of flower. Miss will show it to you now. Okay. So this is orchids. Now, what happened there? She was so happy seeing how beautiful the flowers looked. And she was also surprised by the way the people took care of it. Nurturing means taking care, okay? Bringing up. Nurturing is to bring up the plants. They are grown on hanging wooden planks tied with materials like coconut fiber. Wooden planks are planks kept on a height and from there it is kept hanging from the coconut fiber. What is the coconut fiber? We find some fiber inside the coconut's husk, right? That is called the coconut fiber. And some others grow on the branches of trees. Trees have so many branches and some are grown on that. What is the specialty of orchids? They do not require soil to grow. Almost all plants are grown in the soil, right? Their roots are in the soil. But for orchids, they do not require soil to grow. So now, Vanda is one type of orchid which grows in our locality. We can see it in our house or maybe the neighbor's house, somewhere nearby, okay? It's a common type of orchid. This is called Vanda. It has very thick roots, okay? And these roots have certain peculiarities. What does peculiarities means? It means specialities, okay? These thick roots have some specialities. What is it? They can absorb moisture from the atmosphere. They can take the मॉइस्चर दैट इज वाटर, ओके, वाटरी सब्सटेंस फ्रॉम द एटमोसफियर इट्सेल्फ. अदरवाइज वॉट डू द प्लांट्स डू? द प्लांट्स एब्जॉर्ब द मॉइस्चर फ्रॉम द सॉयल, राइट? वी वाटर द सॉयल एंड प्लांट्स रूट्स टेक वाटर फ्रॉम द सॉयल मॉइस्चर, राइट? इंस्टेड दिस टेक्स फ्रॉम द एटमोसफियर. सो दैट इज वाई दीज प्लांट्स कैन ग्रो इवन विदाउट सॉयल, ओके? And these plants depend on other plants only for shelter. Only for shelter to grow. The rest they take, they absorb the moisture from the atmosphere. They prepare food, everything. But for shelter, they grow on other plants. Okay? They are called epiphytes. What are they called? Epiphytes. Plants which depend on other plants only for shelter are called epiphytes. Plants which depend on other plants only for shelter are known as epiphytes. So have you understood orchids? They belong to which category of plants? There are many more, saprophytes, parasites, and there are lots of plants more. So orchids belong to which types of plants? It belongs to epiphytes. Okay. Now there is a question. Will the presence of epiphytes affect the host plant adversely? What is this host plant? We told that this plant depends on another plant for shelter, right? So the plant on which this orchid depends on is called the host plant. Okay. What is host? For example, when a guest comes to our house, we are the hosts. Okay? So we are doing something for the plant. So they are the superior ones. So will the presence of this epiphytes, that is these in this case orchids, affect the host plants adversely? In a bad way? Will it? So will it, my dear children, will it affect the plant in a bad way? I told you there are more types of plants, parasitic plants, saprophytes, there are so many things coming, parasitic, everything. So epiphytes won't affect the plant in a bad way because it only depends on the other plant for what? For shelter, that is for physical support, for them to grow. They just take the plant, so it does not destroy the other plant. But in different types of plants, in the parasitic plants, we will learn it in the next class, it will affect the host. Okay, it takes the nutrients of the host and prepare food. But in case of epiphytes, it does not adversely affect the host plant. It only takes the physical support, only for shelter. Okay, so my dear students, that was for today. What did we learn? We learned about photosynthesis and respiration. Then we learned about epiphytes. Okay? So photosynthesis, respiration and epiphytes were today's topics. I hope you all have understood the class. If not, we will clear it out during the discussion. So if you like my class, please let me know any feedback of on my videos in the comment box below. So my dear children, we will see the next class in the next week. Till then, bye bye, take care and stay safe.